गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू इन द क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश। दिस इज सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ चैप्टर द नारायणपुर इंसिडेंट। इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो सेशन आई एक्सप्लेन यू द बिगिनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द स्टोरी एंड एज आई टोल्ड यू दिस स्टोरी इज बेस्ड ऑन द क्विट इंडिया मूवमेंट। व्हाट हैपेंड इन अ टाउन, अ स्मॉल टाउन नारायणपुर, दिस इज द स्टोरी रिलेटेड टू दैट। So today we will discuss the middle part of the story, second part of the story, in which we will see how the event proceeds, progresses, and what happens in the middle part. So, as in the first part, you remember very well that Babu and Manju had gone to watch the procession in which their brother Mohan was participating, and you all had seen here that they had gone there, they got the right place to see. And now we will see in this part how the event proceeds. The story develops when the processionists return. We remember very well that they had given a piece of paper to the DSP at the collectorate gates, and they returned. All the processionists returned from there. There were a number of people, a very large crowd, those who were watching. All of them were watching what was going to happen, but nothing happened as the procession was very peaceful. They handed over a piece of paper to the DSP and returned peacefully without speaking, telling any slogans or making any noise. The police wanted so that they could arrest them and put in jail, but nobody did so anything. So the story develops when the processionist returned and Manju and Babu continued their conversation. Manju was disappointed as she expected some interesting and amusing sights there. She thought that something would happen there and that could entertain her. She would be charmed to see the sight. Nothing such happened. So she was a bit disappointed. After returning home, Babu asked Mohan why he had gone back quietly. If they were scared of what the police would do, he asked his brother if they were scared of the police. Mohan replied that the police expected them to do something so that they could put them in jail, but they didn't want to go to jail. When Suman and the boy entered the puja room, then Babu asked their purpose to go there. What was the purpose? Mohan had gone in the procession. Mohan told him that it was like a declaration of war. He told the purpose, why the procession was made, why the people had gone to hand over the piece of paper. He told that it was a declaration of war. They had informed the British that they were their enemy now. We are not going to tolerate anymore there any administration. The piece of paper contained a notice to quit India or face the consequences. Either the British had to leave India, to quit India, or to face the result of this. After dinner, Sumana, another boy, turned up with a large newspaper covered parcel in his hands. Mohan helped them to carry the parcel in the puja room as suggested by his mother. His mother suggested them to take that parcel into his puja room. And so Mohan helped Suman and there was another boy to carry the parcel, which was covered with a newspaper. When Suman and the boy entered the puja room, Manju stared curiously over their shoulders at the mysterious parcel, what the parcel was. which was Cyclostylin Messi. This parcel was a Cyclostylin Messi. Mohan instructed Babu to sit out in the front room and give warning if anyone came. And Manjuwaj instructed to sit in the hall and pass on Babu's warning to them. In this way, Babu and Manju were deputed to their duties. Babu in the front room, Manju in the hall, so that if anyone would come, they would bring the message to him. All of them set on their work. They started, they joined their duty. After some time, a man riding a bike, a man riding a bike stopped right outside their gate. He started opening the gate. Amma got up and came out, followed by Mohan. Suman stayed inside and Mohan closed the door of the room. When the man came to Amma, he recognized the door was open, and when the man saw Amma, he recognized Amma and told that they were in school together. Amma also recognized and called him his name. Patil Sahib, tell me, why are you here? His name was Patil. The man who had come to Mohan's house at that time was Patil. Mr. Patil informed Amma that there was going to be a search in her house that night. He informed her that a search was going to take place in that house, and that's why he had come to inform the family. He told that British officer suspected that they had cyclostyling machine to make copies of Mahatma Gandhi's speech. He told that the British officer suspected that they had kept a cyclostyling machine in their house so that they could make the copies of Mahatma Gandhi's speech. Although Mohan denied, Mohan told no, there is nothing like such. Okay, he denied having any such machine. But his mother accepted that there was. The man who had come, no doubt, had come to inform them so that he could take the machine and protect the family for being searched, so that the British officer could not arrest him with the machine and put him in jail. That's why he had come, for the safety of the family. So no doubt the story is quite related to Quit India movement, and we will see only further in the next part of the story, next part of the pages, what happens, in what way they are really rescued, and what happens, does the search take place in the family or not. All that I will discuss in the next video session. So till then, students, you be safe, be healthy, and go through whole chapter once more, all of you, so that everything will be clear to you when I will explain you the middle part of the story. Thank you, thank you, student, thank you very much.